We know that variation is that component which is selected by, which must be present for the evolutionary process. So किसी भी evolutionary process को continue रहने के लिए या evolution को as a process continue रहने के लिए उस population में variations की presence उसके लिए एक बहुत critically important है. So if there are variations, there will be evolution. In case of genotype. But there are different evolutionary processes which are happening in one population in that environment at same time. For example, we know there is one which is called the natural selection. Similarly, genetic drift है, इसके अलावा gene flow है, इसके अलावा mutation है. ये सारे वो processes हैं which are participating in the process of evolution. So, although variations are present in one population, लेकिन ये possibility कि वो variation किस direction में जाएगी, whether it will be favored by the evolutionary processes or whether it would be discouraged or eliminated by the process of evolution. So there is, but इसकी intensity और इसकी expression जो है, that will be decided by the evolutionary processes occurring in that population. Because there is possibility कि इनमें से ये जो evolutionary processes which I just mentioned, इनमें से एक process तो उस variation को favor कर रहा हो, but at same time there is a second evolutionary process which is going against or it is discouraging the expression of that variation in that population. So there is possibility they are acting together, or there is possibility that evolutionary processes are working in opposition to each other. We know that mutation and genetic drift, they are they might go against the process of natural selection, because these genetic drift and the natural selection, what they are doing, they are removing certain alleles which are not favored by these processes from the one population. For example, natural selection, it is removing the inferior alleles, it is removing those alleles which are reducing the reproductive capacity of that species in that population. But this natural selection is a non-random process. It would select those particular alleles which are doing good, which are having the good variations for the better or the higher reproductive potential, reproductive capacity, and survival of that organism. So it is operating to increase the representation or the frequency of those alleles which are enhancing the reproductive capacity of that individual, which is enhancing those adaptations which are helping those animals to survive in that environment. So that's how the natural selection is working. But genetic drift is random. It won't select specific types of alleles. जिस तरह से नेचुरल सिलेक्शन सिर्फ उन अलील्स को सिलेक्ट कर रही है जो एनिमल की रिप्रोडक्टिव कैपेसिटी को फेवर कर रही है, ऑपोजिट टू दैट जेनेटिक ड्रिफ्ट इज रैंडम. It won't have any standard, or it doesn't have any bias to select certain alleles. So what it is doing, this as a result of this genetic drift, there might be increase in the frequency of inferior alleles. There might be decrease in frequency of superior alleles, or that allele which is favorable. So that's how this genetic drift, it may remove those alleles which are favored by natural selection. Similarly, mutation is also a random process. It may happen for different reasons, but all these reasons are happening randomly. So in that case, mutation also, there is possibility ki mutation bhi un alleles ko us population mein se eliminate kar de which are favored by natural selection. So that's how it is increasing and decreasing the frequency of different alleles. Gene flow is an other evolutionary process, or there is possibility कि यही gene flow it may promote natural selection or it may counter the process of natural selection. So the gene flow, it can be either constructive, because it is bringing the good genes, bringing the good alleles in that population, or it might be a constraining force, because it is removing the good alleles, superior alleles from that population. So it can be there can be a spread of beneficial mutation that arise in one population to the other population, which means that there is a flow of genes from the one population to the other population with the help of this process, evolutionary process, which is called as the gene flow. So this gene flow, because it is introducing genes, it is eliminating genes from the one population, so it can impede those adaptations within that population by the continual flow of inferior alleles from other population, which means that gene flow is bringing inferior alleles from one population to other population. But at same time, ab natural selection kya kar rahi hai? Natural selection is removing that inferior alleles continuously. Gene flow is bringing that inferior allele. So both are acting in opposition to each other. The one example is tolerance of heavy metals in one species of plant, which is called as bent grass. So let's study this example. Bent grass is a species which has a high tolerance for heavy metals, particularly copper. Aur ye un areas mein hai jahan pe there is a mining. So the mining sites, even if they are abandoned and there is no mining activity, phir bhi unme heavy metals ka level, it would remain higher for centuries. Ab wahan par bent grass ki jo species survive kar rahi hai, that species has high tolerance for the heavy metals which are present in the water and the soil of mining site. So they are growing very well. Yahan par heavy metal tolerance ki gene aur allele ko natural selection support kar rahi hai. So resultantly inki survival aur inki reproductive capacity is higher. So they are growing very well. They have a thick population, high density population in that area of mining site. But at same time, gene flow is also acting. Aur gene flow ka process is tarah se function kar raha hai that these plants, the bent grass, they are producing pollens, or ye pollen, they are dispersed by the wind, which is called the air pollination. So pollination ke through, heavy metal tolerance ki gene mining site se flow karti hai and it moves towards other areas. Aur ye wo areas hain jahan par high metal tolerance ki gene ya allele is not present. So wo pollens ya wo seeds jab yahan pe grow karte hain, those pollens which they are involved in fertilization, they are fertilizing the plants in this area. Resultantly jab bent grass with the allele of heavy metal tolerance, these plants, they are not supported by natural selection in that area. To wahi allele jo ke mining site mein natural selection se favor ho rahi hai, same allele in other region, in other population, is not favored by natural selection. The reason is ki yahan par wo plants hain which have better alleles to occupy the niche in that habitat. So they are growing better, they are increasing their population size at higher rate. So the bent grass is not able to compete here in this habitat. Aur natural selection ke process ke through, inki bent grass ki wo population jisme ke heavy metal tolerance ki allele hai, that is eliminated from this population. So that's how gene flow is bringing this allele from this population to this population. Aur ye continuously air ke through, pollination ke through, in alleles ko is population se is population mein move kara rahi hain. But natural selection is removing these alleles, gene flow is adding these alleles. So this is one example jiske through hum ye jaan sakte hain ki evolutionary processes sometimes ye ek dusre ke sath milke kaam karte hain, they support each other, but at same time they may work in opposition to each other. Aur koi bhi variation kitni intensity mein kis population mein appear hogi, that depends upon this interaction of evolutionary processes.